Jason here from Off-Road Living, here to talk to you about batteries, what's so good about AllSpark batteries, and why you should buy our battery in comparison to other battery manufacturers' products. Why should you buy an AllSpark battery? Well, there's a couple of reasons why. We will never compromise on the quality of the raw materials used to make the battery, to make the cells, to make the cases, to make the whole of battery product that ultimately you purchase. We use the very best materials to make the cells, very best materials and components to make the BMS. We make our cells and we make our BMS for a high duty rate application, especially for those of you that want to run inverters, to run induction cooktops, air conditioning, coffee machines, kettles, toasters, microwaves. A lot of the batteries out there only have a very low duty rating, 100 amp continuous, or some of them even are only 50 amp continuous output. Fine if you're just running some lights and a small fridge, but if you want any of the higher applications of running inverters or air compressors and those sorts of things, you need to have cells and a BMS that can handle that high continuous output current. We have proven the cycle rates of our batteries in a laboratory testing facility. Took about 8.5 months to do this process. You charge the battery, you discharge the battery, you recharge the battery, you do that cycle after cycle after cycle. It sits there and charges away, and we measure the capacity remaining in the battery after each cycle. We put that battery through its paces, or 1,000 cycles, 2,000 cycles, 3,000 cycles, all the way up to 5,000 cycles, and we measure the residual capacity that's remaining after all of those cycle counts. Many manufacturers are falsely that their batteries will last for 5,000 cycles at an 80% depth discharge. Quite frankly, it's a lot of BS. For a manufacturer to claim that, what they're saying is that if you discharge your battery every day, 80% of depth of discharge, that battery is going to last for in excess of 14 years. I question whether any of them ever done any age testing or cycle testing of their products. And quite frankly, the majority of these batteries are now starting 5,000 cycles. Only 12 months ago, we're for the same make and model of battery, we're claiming 2,000. So it's false marketing. They get away with it because the vast majority of customers don't have any ability to check it or test it or even know that it's not actually correct information. A battery that has 5,000 cycles shouldn't have a 1 or 2 or 3 year warranty. It should come with a 10 or a 12 or 15 year warranty if that was legitimately a possible outcome for that battery. From a quality perspective, from our AllSpark batteries, we only use large format resistance match prismatic cells. We don't use cylindrical cells, we don't use pouch cells. We certainly don't use second hand cells, which the vast majority of cheap batteries on the market are actually operating with. A lot of customers don't understand that a battery, 100 amp hour lithium battery that you buy for $400, $500, $600 is not made with brand new cells. Quite a lot of those products that are out there are made using secondhand recycled cells that have been taken out of a UPS type facility where the batteries that are at the end of its life for that purpose, they then get repurposed, re-stickered essentially, and then put into a new battery for a different application. Those batteries are not going to last for the 5,000 cycles that they're claiming. They're certainly not going to last for the 5 or 6 or 10 years that they are marketing for them. That's why they have much lower warranties. The quality of our batteries use brand new cells, the highest quality materials, using copper bus bar connections, laser welding techniques to remove any potential for breakage during high vibration environments, corrugations and the like in Australian off-road conditions. They're terrible for destroying all sorts of components, suspension and electronic components and those sort of things. So we've designed them to be really robust. They last the distance. They're not going to be damaged in off-road conditions. What you get from us is what we claim in our marketing materials. That's proven product that is going to last for a long period of time, and in some applications it may even outlast your vehicle. We've been manufacturing lithium batteries at Off-Road Living since 2017. We've got more than 10,000 batteries are being produced across the Australian market in that time. We have a very high success rate as a result of the high quality components. Within that period of time, we've had less than this sort of number of batteries back under a warranty that have actually genuinely had a problem. Three of those have been water damaged as a result of incorrect applications for batteries that weren't waterproof, so the wrong applications of those. Two genuine actual faults of a cell or a BMS. Outside of that, we've got 100% success rate with our batteries during that 7-year period.
That's why we're excited to announce that we're extending the warranty across our entire AllSpark battery range. Was a 5-year full replacement in the warranty. We now have a 7-year full replacement warranty across the entire AllSpark lithium battery range. With more than 10,000 customers across Australia running AllSpark batteries, we've proven the reliability not only in the laboratory conditions, but we've also proven them in real world conditions. As a result of that, we're so certain about its reliability and its longevity, we now offer a 7-year full replacement warranty across the full range of AllSpark lithium batteries. What is a C-rate? A C-rate is a measure of a battery's current rating and its capacity, right? So there's a number of factors that go into that. Our AllSpark batteries are all rated using a C5 rate. What does that mean? It means that if you're evenly discharging the full capacity of that battery over a 5-hour period, you get the rated capacity of that battery. So as an example, a 100 amp hour battery with a C5 rating can be evenly discharged over a 5-hour period at 20 amps to produce 100 amp hours. If you tried to take the same battery and you discharge them at 200 amps for 30 minutes, you wouldn't get the full 100 amp hours of capacity out of that battery. Essentially, the faster you discharge a battery, the less capacity you'll get during that cycle in comparison to if it was done at a shorter rate. Inversely to that, if you were discharging at a much slower rate, for example, only a 2 amp hour discharge per hour, then you might actually get an increase of, say, 105, 108 amp hours from the battery during that cycle. So it all comes down to the rate at which you discharge, how much heat it generates. The faster you discharge it, the less efficiently it can produce that capacity. The slower you discharge it, the higher the efficiency in discharging the battery and slightly higher in total discharge capacity for that cycle.
There's a raft of benefits that come with the lithium batteries. Putting the cost aside for a minute, lithium batteries are around about a quarter of the weight of an AGM battery. So with the vehicles, with GVM limits and all those sorts of things, both with four-wheel drives and with caravans and camper trailers, lots of people have weight limits. So there's a weight advantage that comes with that. You can take 220 amp hour AGMs out of a vehicle, weighing 35 odd kilos each, so 70 kilos in total, replace that with a single 1920 kilo, 150 amp hour battery, for example, as a comparison. So that battery at 19 kilos versus 70 kilos, you've got a 50 kilo weight limit. So there's a weight advantage.
Two-thirds of the physical size for the equivalent usable capacity. So there's a space saving that allows you to reduce the volume that it takes up for your batteries and charging systems, gives you more storage space in your vehicles.
Charging and discharging efficiency. So AGM battery is very poor at absorbing charge current at low states of charge and also at the top end of its charging stages, right?
You need to put in a lot more amp hours for the battery to absorb that energy. With a lithium battery, it takes all of the energy almost at 96%.
So it's almost everything that you put into it gets absorbed by that battery during the charge state. It does it very efficiently during the discharge cycle as well.
Why is this important? Well, if you've got limited charge capability, especially when you're charging from solar, you've only got a certain number of hours per day that you can charge your batteries with. You've only got a certain amount of hours per day until the sun goes down.
You need to be able to get as much of that usable energy and that limited energy source that you have and get that into your batteries. Lithium batteries will absorb that very quickly. AGM batteries are a lot less efficient at absorbing that power.
Cycle life is one of the key differences, right? A good quality AGM, a premium AGM battery, you might get 500 to 800 cycles out of a battery over a period of time.
Cycle life is important. With an AGM battery, you might only get 800 cycles out of a premium grade AGM. A cheap quality AGM might only get 300 to 500 cycles out of that during its lifetime.
Lithium batteries, on the flip side of that, especially with an AllSpark battery, you're getting batteries in excess of 3,000 cycles. Over that duration, at the end of those 3,000 cycles, we're not putting that battery in the bin by any means. It's still maintaining an 85% residual capacity from its original capacity after those 3,000 cycles. You continue to use that for many thousand cycles after that point and get many, many years of life out of that. An AGM battery, in comparison, When it gets to the end of its cycle life, the battery deteriorates to a point where it won't charge, it won't discharge, it won't maintain its original capabilities. It generally will drop a cell during that period of time, and it can't produce the power that you need it to do. So there's a life expectancy that drops away quite significantly with AGM batteries. That is not the case with good quality lithium batteries like an AllSpark battery. We get a lot of questions from customers of why your battery is better than others. Well, quite frankly, it's because of the best quality components and materials that go into making those batteries. We make a battery with a high continuous duty rating. What does that mean? It means it can produce a higher output current on a continuous basis for the full duration of its cycle count. Some will claim to have a high duty rating, but it's only for 5 minutes or 25 minutes or only at a certain temperature or only a certain number of degrees. AllSpark batteries have a high continuous output current for the full discharge capability of that battery. AllSpark batteries are designed to operate between minus 20 degrees and up to 65 degrees. Once you get over 65 degrees, there's not really any batteries of any style or any capability that can operate in temperatures over and above that. But the reality is, even in the really extremes of temperature in the Australian summer, in getting up to air temperature to 45 or 48 degrees, the internal cell temperature of a battery never really is going to exceed 65 degrees. As a result, that battery will continue to perform flawlessly throughout its entire life. If the battery, for some reason, was exposed to very high continuous temperatures, i.e. in an engine bay, then the battery would go into its high temperature protection mode, automatically protected by the battery management system in the battery. This is why, at AllSpark, we don't recommend putting lithium batteries in the engine bay. Lithium battery cells should be protected at 65 degrees. Some of the companies out there, the cell batteries, they say they're suitable for in-engine bay applications, have simply bypassed the temperature protections in their BMS to allow that battery to continue to operate in high temperature environments. It's not safe for the battery, it's not safe for your vehicle, it's not good for the longevity of the battery as well. We have proper protections in place to protect the battery from extremes of temperature in normal current applications, in normal installations where the battery is installed where it should be. It will operate seamlessly, it will operate flawlessly in all temperature conditions all the way through summer and winter in Australian conditions. One of the most common questions you get is, can I use my AGM battery charger to charge my lithium battery? Well, we've got a very good article on our website. There'll be a link below this video somewhere. In that article, we run through all the pros and cons of using different types of chargers. But one of the fundamental differences between an AGM charger and a lithium battery charger is the charging profile that it uses for a lithium battery is very different to that of an AGM battery. When you charge a battery, it goes all the way up to 14.6 volts for a lithium battery. It drops away to 13.6 volts as a float charge versus trickle charge stage, right? That charger, if it's an AGM battery charger and it doesn't know that it's a lithium battery, it won't kick back in to start recharging until the battery has discharged itself down to around about 12.7 to 12.8 on most battery chargers. Fine for a lead acid battery, an AGM battery, because when it drops away to that, it's only a few percentage. But if you do that with a lithium battery, you've got to discharge that battery more than 80% of its capacity before the voltage will drop away to that point. That means that you could go a day or two or three, depending on the capacity of the battery, before your charger kicks back in and starts recharging that battery. That's why there's manufacturers out there that claim you can drop a lithium battery into your system, not have to change your chargers out. But really, that's a load of BS. The charger will work sometimes. It won't work efficiently. It won't work all the time. And it certainly won't work the way that it needs to charge a lithium iron phosphate battery. Why is continuous output duty rating of a battery important? Well, even in our smallest battery that we produce, 100 amp hour lithium iron phosphate battery, it has 175 amp continuous output current. We do have models in those sizes and beyond with a 200 amp continuous output as well. 175 amp continuous output is enough to run a 2000 watt inverter from a single battery. That means with AllSpark, If you want a 2000 watt inverter to run your coffee machine or a counter or a toaster or a microwave, whatever those appliances are, but you're only for using them for short periods of time, you don't need a massive capacity battery. You certainly don't have to put two of them in parallel to be able to produce that continuous output current to be able to run that inverter. It has a lower total cost to get your system installed, still allows you to run those appliances from home from a single battery without having to buy two. Saves you on space, saves you on dollars, saves you on headaches as well. Because we're so confident in the longevity and the reliability of batteries, not only are we offering you a full replacement warranty for 7 years, in the extremely unlikely event that you needed to send your battery back to us for an inspection, testing, or warranty purposes, we will cover the cost of shipping the battery back to our warehouse and back to you as a replacement. Like with all our products, if you're still not sure about what we've supplied in this video today, if you have any technical questions, we've got a team of experts here at Wyford Living that can help you with your inquiries. Drop us a note on an email, give us a call, talk to us on the chat function on the website. Get in touch. We can offer you the right technical advice to help you select the battery that's right for your applications.